saving a lot of these empty used toilet rolls. So what you can do with these is you literally just tear them up into little pieces about that big and toss them in and mix them in with the soil. And you can even use the ones that have got the tissue stuck to them, that's going to break down as well, and it's going to give the compost some much needed dry ingredients and rejuvenation. I don't remember the
hang on a minute, what is that ninny talking about? I actually meant to say was green components versus brown components. Now green components are things that you can get from your kitchen, like potato skins and carrot tops and things like that. You chuck them in to the composter and they break down and nourish the soil. Brown components are things like cardboard or dried leaves, dead plants, things like that. And they break down and add structure to the soil. Now what I'll do here is put the totals of the different components that you'd actually need to make a good compost up on the screen so you can see what I was actually trying to get across to you guys.
I'll put it up somewhere on the screen here and you'll be able to see what mixture you need for a good compost. So with that, let's go out. Something that's kind of boring, but just get to sit and enjoy the environment that you're in. I know my body's going to punish me for doing this later, because something like this is a massive fibro trigger for me personally. Alright, there we go. That is about as mixed as I can get it right now. My fibro is really, really starting to trigger, so I'm going to leave it at that and I'll give it about a week, and if it's still a bit meh, then I shall add in some more of the loo rolls. I've put in about half a bag full, or more than half the bag, so hopefully that should add some much needed brown material to some rather soggy compost. So I'll put the lid on there and we'll leave that for next time. One more job to top the list. It's not a bad job to do, just have to kind of get over